So I also bought from Nering's kind of accessories for turbo replacement. There are quite a few things inside. I mean, I've opened it, it's a bit dirty, but it's quite a few things. So there's the oil return pipe. I already tried to refit it there, so it's proper tight. So I'll have to fit. So that's the oil return from the turbo. Another thing is the actual oil, the pressure oil that comes from the crankcase, from the filter. That's also there. And what I'll do with that, I'll put my finger there and actually blow the whole thing. I mean, you can reuse the old one, but I'll be using this new one in case there is anything inside. But it's fairly unlikely, and I'll have a kind of a spare for that one. Next thing in the bag is oil pickup, brand new oil pickup with bolts. From the filter down there, it's not blocked. But also, well, actually, and that's it. So there is quite a few bits and pieces here. It's actually a good kit, a bit expensive, but it's actually quite good. So there is a additional oil return, but it's slightly kinked. So I don't really like that. I don't want it to be kinked, so to stop the flow of the flow of the oil. So I'm not using that, so I'll be using the old one. It's got two O-rings. That's for the turbo on top. Also, it's got the two banjo bolts with four washers. So crucially, this is the old banjo bolt. I'm not too sure if one can see it. This is the old banjo bolt. So it's got a really a small. I'm not too sure if it can be seen. I'll try to shine the torch there. So hopefully that's visible. There is a small filter there. But this is really pretty, it's extremely clean, this filter. There is nothing really that has blocked it. So actually that's quite good, and this has lasted roughly about 105,000 miles, this small filter. But that's the old design, this banjo bolt. So some people really just remove that one altogether. But if there is any crud or some really small bits and pieces, they will end up in the turbo on the shaft. So I'm kind of torn whether I should keep it or replace it, so one can just wash it and put it again. And this is the banjo bolt, and that's the new design. It's got a plastic element. It's got a plastic element there, and that's really the new design. Let me open that one. Let me open it. So that's the new design, which has a much larger element. Maybe it's a bit finer, I'm not too sure, but it's along the length of the whole, right, so it goes like that, the length of the whole thing. So it does. This is really more likely to be, this is the new design. The old one, my previous one was the old design with this banjo bolt here. This is kind of quite big, so it won't really get clogged that much. So I'll probably keep that one altogether. Won't be removing it. I'm sure a lot of people will say, "Oh yeah, remove that one. It's reducing the flow." But I might eventually remove it. But for the moment, I'll leave it as it is. This is kind of the new design. So that's it for this kit. So next thing is really to shove this one, and that's quite a. It's quite a tough one, so I have to kind of plug it in that hole down there. It's sticking out. I'll show it in a second. So here is where this needs to go. That's the oil return. This has to kind of go on top. I'm not gonna film it because it's a very tight, and it has to be pushed quite a bit. So it's a lot of effort, but it's basically pushing it there to stick like that when the turbo is. When the cartridge is put in, so it plugs on top. But yeah, I'll try to do it now. So I really decided to use the original hose because that one was like huge effort to actually put it somewhere to here. It was huge effort. I couldn't quite put it in the turbo is really huge effort. That's a lot easier. And it's an old one, but so what? I can someday replace it, but it's probably gonna be all right anyway. So that's much easier to kind of fit in, much easier to fit in the turbo. I mean, it go very easy. Otherwise, the other was I was struggling so much that I thought that this edge is cutting inside the rubber of the other one, not this the original one. So I'll be using. I'll just stick it in from the bottom, and then this, because it slides very easy, I'll stick it from the top. So that was really a lot easier to hook down there, much, much easier. So I can now just slide it in and hook it to the exhaust turbine, and then clamp it together so it will stay. So kind of stay together, otherwise they really, this is the only thing that's holding the turbo to the exhaust side part is only this clamp. So here is how it's behind there. So that's the O-return. Here comes down. That's the clamp there. So that's the O-return. Nothing really complicated. It was just a matter of just sliding the whole tube inside. So okay. So first, trying to. See if there are any, by any chance, if there are any bits and pieces, but it's unlikely. Next is to stick it in there, which actually should be fairly easy, and it's extremely easy to put in. Next thing, there is a pin here, and if you see this, the video that is in the description, how there is a pin here, that there is also a hole in the turbo, so it actually is only one way this could go. There is no actually any different. There are no other different ways. So this plate also has to be kind of central, otherwise it won't slide in. There we go, that's actually pretty good. And I'll clamp it only slightly, otherwise I have to clamp it, otherwise this will actually slip. Part of my thing disappeared, part of my protection aluminium foil. So yeah, that's actually kind of okay. So I'll put the bolt inside, so it's a square bolt. And on top, so kind of to hold it together. So one can slightly hammer it all around just to put this one in, but I don't think it's entirely necessary, but I can only slightly hammer it, just very slightly, just to go kind of to only to send shockwaves, not really to hammer it. From the other side, I cannot quite, I can only slightly. What actually would like to do, I have this mirror, so I'll have a look around to see if that's positioned all right. Yeah, that's actually good. And for that bolt, I don't want to remove that one. So for that bolt, I don't really know, there is no, let me move the camera a bit. So that bolt, there is no torque, but what I did before, so one has to actually also, one has to spin that side to make sure that the propeller from the exhaust side doesn't touch. So you have to really spin it from that side carefully and just make sure that it spins all right and it's nice and doesn't stop anywhere. But the other thing is I measured, really this is 7.5 millimeters down here, how much it was before, but roughly about, I'll probably do about the same, about 7.5 mil or so just to tie it up closer, not too much, but just to tie it. It wasn't that tight to begin with, the original wasn't really that tight. Still to go. And of course, again, check if this rotates nice and freely. So I've tightened that nut. Well, I'm not too sure how much, because I measured the distance, so roughly about the same distance that was before, so not to be too much, not too little. I mean, it, still you can go, but it's very small boat, so I didn't really do it too much. So the other thing is to put both your fingers inside and rotate them from both sides, and to see if the two propellers are not stopped by anything. So you basically rotate it and you just feel it. Don't really push the shaft too much, otherwise the propellers could be stopped from the metal. But they should be really freely rotated, so inspect it. Next thing is really to fit that the oil feed pipe. There is only one position that this could be fitted. This could be done. And so here now it's a two kind of pictures of how one can do it. So the bottom one, you have to find 7.5 millimeter something from a drill or something that has to be put in between the joint and the metal there, and then this has to be the torque is 30 newton meters while this is there, so it doesn't really slip and move. On the bottom it's a 20.5 millimeter that you put, so the bottom is 7.5 millimeter, the top is 20.5 millimeters, and you just tie it again 30 with the two washers, 30 newton meters torque. So that's really the next phase. From these two slides, I managed to, I don't really have a 20.5 millimeter, so I found this 15 millimeter socket, and that's exactly 20.5 millimeter. So I can use that one to stick it around here and then tighten it to 30 newton meters. For the 7.5 at the bottom, I have this. I bought these left hand drills. These are kind of to drill out a variety of bolts. Let me measure that one. Yeah, that's exactly 7.5. So 1/64 and left hand side drill. So basically you have to find something that is 7.5 millimeters. So one thing about fitting those, I mean, one can put it in like that, and then kind of pre-tighten it, but not too much from the bottom, not too much, and from the top, not really, just tighten it and then actually apply the actual torque. So we'll first tie up the top bolt, and that's the one banjo bolt without the filter that goes on top to nuts to go around it. So I'll have to remove that for the oil. Then do that on the bottom, and on the not to slip somewhere, because it's quite awkward. So it has to go like that, and then then it's tied up. Next thing is to put it on and just kind of tighten it, not really too much, just only slightly, just to be like sitting there. The next thing is from the bottom, same stuff. So I've decided actually to fit the bottom one first rather than second, because it might be slightly easier. I'm also keeping the the filter there.
Yeah, I've decided to keep it. I mean, it's been currently so far it's been not a problem. So if I keep changing the oil, that should be actually
probably all right. It's a bit on the difficult side to fit that one in. There we go. The first one is tight, and here is what I was talking about. This pin goes to about there, and then that's left in there, and I think it's about here. I have to actually check which one on the picture, but it comes here and it gets tightened. Yeah, comes about here and stays there, and then gets torqued. And I'll put the because the camera is down there, it's a bit difficult to film, so I'll put the top one, but it's not really, it's basically the same procedure. It's not nothing really, nothing complicated. It's just tightening it, not really that much, just a little bit tightening. So next thing is to tighten that bolt, and I've put the 7.5 millimeter left-handed side drill there, so it will be it will stop it moving when I tighten it, stop it really moving. So 30 newton meters. Let's see how this will go. That's 30. 30 plus minus 5. Oh, that's actually alright. Managed to tighten it. This is 7.5, that's actually good there. That's actually perfect according to the picture. Isn't really touching any of the other sides. So that's actually it's actually quite good. So one last thing, I've tightened it up, but I'll undo it just to see the strengthening, kind of the how it moves and where it needs where it's going. So it's a bit pointing towards that direction, so when it's tight it will move, so one needs to put that pin there, so when it's tightening this will shift that direction. I mean, next thing it's do the filter and the oil filter. Assemble everything around here, and then put some oil in, and then start it. See how this new turbo will work.